Let's talk about ratios and proportions from the variable parts perspective. In this video, we'll focus on representations. I'm assuming you've already watched the multiple batches videos, so we're going to build on that information. We're continuing with our favorite trail mix recipe that calls for 3 parts nuts for every 2 parts of dried fruit. Now we want to use 12 cups of nuts, and we're asking how many cups of dried fruit do I need to make my favorite trail mix. The multiple batches perspective, we will start with our ratio, and then we'll repeat it as if we're making 1 batch of the recipe, a 2nd batch of the recipe, a 3rd and 4th batch of the recipe, until we get to our desired amount, in this case our 12 cups, and we can look and see that we're going to need 8 cups of dried fruit. The variable parts takes a different approach. So we start with the same 3-to-2 ratio, but instead of repeating batch after batch, we're going to say let's change the value of each part. So if I know my 3 parts of nuts corresponds to 12 cups of nuts, well, I can use division. 12 cups divided by 3 parts means that each of the parts has to be worth 4 cups. So once I know the value of one part, I'm going to extend that to the value of all parts. So each of my parts is worth 4 cups, which means that I'm going to need a total of 8 cups of dried fruit. We can represent this with a strip diagram. A strip diagram just uses rectangles rather than bubbles and usually separates out each part of the ratio. So for example, I could have my nuts and my fruit, and I would draw my nuts with a rectangle divided into 3 equal parts, and then I would draw my fruit such that the 2 equal parts were the same size, or each individual part was the same size. Then I use the same kind of reasoning that I did above. So here my 3 parts are worth a total of 12 cups, which means that I need to have 12 divided by 3 parts to get 4 cups per part. Once I know the value of one part, I know the value of all parts. So I can answer all kinds of different questions here. I could say that I needed 8 cups of fruit. I could say that I needed a total of 20 cups of the trail mix. Or I could even look here and say I need 4 more cups of nuts than I need of fruit. With strip diagrams, it's relatively straightforward to work with numbers that are not multiples of your original ratio. I'll start with the same diagram. I have my 3 parts nuts to 2 parts fruit. And if I know my 2 parts of fruit correspond to 1 cup, here I'm going to take 1 cup divided by 2 parts, and I'll get 1/2 of a cup per part. So each part is worth 1/2. Once I know the value of one part, I know the value of all the parts, and so I can see that I'm going to need a total of 1.5 cups of nuts. I can look at totals as well. So if I take my 3-to-2 ratio, labeling the different quantities here, nuts versus fruit. And now I know that I want a total of 25 cups of trail mix. So I can take my 25 cups divided by 5 parts means that I'm going to have 5 cups per part. 5 cups for each part. I know the value of one part, and I assign that to each additional part, and I can say, well, that means I need 10 cups of fruit, I need 15 cups of nuts, I'm going to use 5 more cups of nuts than fruit right here. We can still use our ratio table. Lots of people like the ratio table, so we can have nuts, fruit. Build our table. We start with our original ratio of 3 to 2. And now instead of saying how many batches of 3, I'm saying I have 3 parts. What's the value of each part? Our original word problem, we wanted 12 cups of nuts. So if I have 3 parts, each worth 4 cups, then I'm using my multiplicative reasoning here and coming up with 8 cups of fruit. So we're just twisting it around. Instead of how many groups of 3, we're now saying 3 groups of what amount?